Very good morning, one and all. Now we are going to do our next practical. In this practical, we are going to do how to digitize a topo sheet. But before going to start our today's practical, we'll just have a brief discussion about the yesterday's practical. Then we'll move ahead with the yesterday's. First, we'll clear the yesterday's query. Then we'll start our today's practical. I am just adding the yesterday's data, which practical we already completed. Okay, this is our yesterday's data. Already we worked there. I have received your respondents also. Whatever task you have completed at your home, you have submitted me through email. Some people they have sent me on WhatsApp also. Very nicely you are working on this task. It is very nice to see. I have to just add one more thing, which we did not cover in yesterday's practical, and some participant they asked me regarding that part. And then I thought we should go with that practical. That is just 5 minutes thing. I will just cover that one, and then we'll start today's practical. Okay, I'm just opening the properties. Just double click over here on our layer. Here we gone through the symbology. Everything you know. How to change the color, pattern, everything. Now I have to tell one more thing extra, that is, suppose you have a data with you. Yesterday we had discussed on the population data. Suppose you have a population data, density data, sex ratio, literacy. Then you have to generate a map. When we are generating map, that time what we are doing, we are classifying that available data in different classes. Okay, and on the basis of that, we are generating our map. We didn't cover that part yesterday. That's why I'm taking this 5 minute session in today's practical. Just go to here in simple, go to here and graduated. That fourth option is there, graduated. Just click over there. When you click there, that time the downside, that another option will appear, that is the value. Just go here and select the variable. On which variable you are going to generate your map. Means suppose you have to generate map on sex ratio, you can add the sex ratio. Suppose you have to, you want to generate a map on density, you have to add the density data. Whatever map you have to generate, that variable you have to add here. Now I am going to add, suppose, density. Okay, I added here density. Now next one, that is the symbol. Go to here, click here. Whatever type of pattern you want, you can change according to that. Here, yesterday we already discussed there. Suppose I took this one. Okay, now this is again color ramp. You can change the color ramp also for that whatever classes you are going to do for that. Now here, come downside. Here classes. How many number of classes do you want? 5, 6, 7, like that. But 5 is sufficient number. It is very nicely, it will represent there. We can add there also. This is the thing. Now suppose you do not want to, I don't like this color. Then just go here, double click, and whatever color you want, according to that, you can assign the color like that. This one. Here what is happening, it is taking the both the color, it is the merge of that two colors, it is taking that both the colors here. Likewise we can change the color. Then see, now what is the things here is the value. The value minimum density is 101 and maximum density is 29,203. That is the maximum density. Now from here to here, it has splitted in different section, first, second, third, fourth, fifth. Now suppose you do not want to such type of classification because you feel your data is not nicely represented in that file class, then what you have to do, you have to just come here, this mode, this option, equal count, click here. When you will click there, that time different options will appear there, equal interval, logarithmic scale, natural break, pretty break, breaks, standard deviation. Suppose we will go through the natural breaks, then what will happen, whatever naturally breaks are there in your data, according to that, that will classified. Suppose we go with the equal interval, I will go with the equal interval, means whatever data is available there, and in that case equally distribute, and it will classify in five part. Okay, suppose you want to go with the standard deviation, in standard deviation also they can do this one. Just I will change here classes. It is showing here standard deviation is less than 4.89. okay, here also it will show some class. Okay, here in this standard deviation, what they did, 1 minute, I'll just cancel this class. Here our minimum value is 101 and maximum value is 29,000, something like that. It is made here a standard deviation, that is the less than 4.89, and according to that it has created a single class. Okay, the all value will show here in a single class, then it is not nice representation. Then we'll go through with another one. Okay, a pretty breaks, that one classification is there, and it is dividing the classes according to that. Then you have to choose which is appropriate option for us to represent the our data. One more thing I want to add here. See, now suppose these are the value, okay, and this value is representing here in the legend, means when we will create our map final layout, that time this value will appear on your map. Then now up to you, suppose you want to make some minor changes here, then we can do that changes. Means what we have to do, we have to just click here on this line, with the double click that figure get selected. Okay, then suppose I want to do here, is that is showing the 101, but suppose I want to made a round figure, because all other figures are in a round figure, then I made this one. Otherwise I want to do another one. Suppose I do not want that 100, I want to just give the less than 5000, and here with the double click I want to just do the above 25, like that. See, now here what is that, less than 5000, 5000 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, and above 25. Like that we can generate a map. And suppose you have some another idea, you have some another innovative idea, according to that we have to change, you can do that one also. Then simply, I do not want this color, I will go with the black innovative. Let's specify it won't look nice. I'll just change the color here. Okay, apply. And okay, see here, what happens here? Now less than 5000, 5, 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20, 25 and above 24. Again from here also we can change the color like that. See here, now you can give this color also. I'm just randomly selecting the color. Okay, let me check the properties. Attribute table, density. Here is the density. We'll minimize the attribute table for just cross checking either what we are doing is it correctly or not. See density 5000 to 25. See here. Okay, what thing is that? Now see, you just cross check with this data. Now see density. Now what is there? Maximum part. See, minimum 101. Here 101, 7, 48, 26. Last one, 4, 4, 3, 1, 8, 0, 2. Okay, last this one means all that numbers is falling down in this section less than 5000. Okay, and the only one that is the 29. 203, that is comes are under here above. Now I want to just check here which part is that last one. That is the showing Pune city. Now our whatever data we have generated here, that is correct only. Okay, whatever data we have generated, I am just removing that data. Okay, now we are going to perform our today's practical, that is digitization. Okay, when we are performing digitization, that time what we are actually doing, what is that process digitization? Digitization is a process we are converting analog data to digital data. Okay, analog data, what is the physical data we are converting into digital data, digital format. Now in the case of JS, what we are doing, we are using the raster data set. We are converting that raster data set into vector data set or vectorization. That is the process we can call as a vectorization also. Why we are converting raster data into vector data or vectorization? Because for the handling the data, whatever available data, for the handling the data, it is most suitable to handle the vector data, and for the, our further analysis also, it is more easy for the doing the further analysis. Okay, very important thing is that whenever we are starting any kind of work, any kind of project, anything, that time this is the first step to perform the digitization. Now we are going to do that part. Before that, I want to just link the sequence. What till now we learn? We have gone through raster data, vector data, then georeferencing, then datum, then projection. Okay, now when I am going to add the data and we are going to perform the digitization, that simultaneously I am going to tell some important points as well. And whatever things we are covering in our session, a practical, that only we are going to ask in the our final exam also. Okay, we are not going to ask beyond the our syllabus. Whatever things we learned here, that things only we are going to ask in the practical our exam. Okay, now here I am going to add today's work data. Yesterday only I have messaged you on Telegram. What data we have to use here? We have to use the yesterday's georeference topo sheet. Okay, by using that we are going to perform the digitization. This is very important. Before going to digitization, your data, whatever map, topo sheet, anything that is called as a base map, it should be a georeference. Without georeference, the data is a meaningless. Now first we have to add that raster data. Be remember, we have to add the yesterday's georeference topo sheet. I'm just adding that topo sheet here. This is the my file. Yesterday when we did that georeference, that time I have saved that georeference file in the practice folder with the name georef. Okay, now that data is with us. In the beginning only I inform that whatever task we are going to hear, that is depend on each other. That's why we have to go with the sequence here, otherwise you miss the things. Now here, whenever the way I am moving the cursor, same way these values are going to change. See, just look at here on this figure. See why? Because this is the georeference. I am just doing zoom in. Okay, now here I am going to tell you the important things about the digitization, but that doesn't mean is that is the final things. You have to improve your skill by your own practice. Whenever you will do your actual work, that time you feel you understand what are the difficulties over there. Orally I can tell you, you can listen, but when you are going to do actual practical things, that time only you get to know what actual difficulty you feel. Okay, then your practice is very important. And whatever task I am giving you, you just complete that one. That is not for me, but for your practice it is very important. Many participants, they are completing their task, they are discussing with me, they are sending their final output, and on the basis of that, whatever difficulties they are facing, they are telling me, and in the next session that same difficulties I am describing here. Suppose you are not doing your task, your practice, then it will be a difficult to know the extra things. Okay, now here we are ready with our topo sheet. Now we have to add our layers. Go to layer. Till now what we did in this section, we did this one, add layer. Till today we just handle the available data, but we nowhere generated our own data. Now suppose you have to work your own data, your own project, MPhil, dissertation, PhD, any kind of your work, that time what we have to do, mostly when I am talking about geography, that time people do use a topo sheet as a base map. But it doesn't mean that is the only base map. Suppose you are working on some other fields, then you can use a geological map use your basic map in the field of geology. Suppose you are working on soil science, then whatever your soil map, that will be your base map. On the basis of that, you can convert that raster data into vector data, and it will be useful for your further analysis. But now here we are not going to use this data because we have to generate a layer. Okay, now go to here, create layer. In the create layer, different options are there. Out of that, we have to use the new shapefile layer. Okay, we have to just click over there. When we are clicking there, then new window will appear in front of you on your screen with the name of new shapefile layer. Be remember, in the first onwards only, I am telling in the real world, whatever scenario is present there, that is everything is present there. But when we are dealing with the GIS platform, that time we have to generate everything in the form of layer. Okay, each and everything. Whatever things we are going to do here, that will be in the layer format. Means what kind of layer? Means suppose I will take the example of one. See, go here. This is our actual world. This is our topo sheet. What things are visible there? See, this is the main highway. Okay, this is the main highway. This is also road inside the city. Okay, then here is some agriculture area. This is the agriculture area. This is the barren land. This is the built up area. Somewhere here I have to just zoom in the thing. But now this window is opened here. That's why it will not get to any zoom in or zoom out. First we will complete this one and then we will go there. My concern is that I am just telling to you many things are there, but at the same time we are not going to do everything at the same time. We have to generate a layer, and after completion of digitize or layer, we have to maintain, we have to build that layer as per our requirement. Means the way we are arranging that point, line, polygon, everything according to that, we have to arrange that all layers. Now here I am going to give the file name. What I am going to do? I am going to do giving the path. Just browse the button. I have made one folder, that is the practice. Whatever things we are doing, I am just saving in that practice folder. This is really nice practice. Whenever you are doing any work, that time create a separate folder for that all work. Suppose you are dumping all your work anywhere, then it is very difficult to find out again. Okay, now here see, everything I have kept very nicely, then it will very easy to understand. Now I'm saving here, test. Here is the format of that file, that is the .ssb H3 shape file, where I saved Ravindra Mere, that is my computer name, D drive, QGIS folder, in that workshop folder, in that practice folder, I am going to save this file, test. Save. That path will appear here. See, that path will appear here. Okay. Now here in geometry type, this is very important in geometry type. See here. Now you are very much familiar with the point, line and polygons. Okay. Which feature you are going to digitize, according to that you have to select the geometry type. Okay, now here is up to you which area you have to digitize. Okay, suppose I have to digitize a temple, a small building, tree, electric pole, telephone pole, tower, that time I have to use the point geometry type. Okay, then regarding that multi line we will discuss later. First the major point we will discuss, that one, point, line and polygon. The next one, that is the line. In the line feature, many line features are available there on your screen. See, road, these are the road. Suppose we go downside, might be river is there, canal is there, that all features will fall down in a line. Okay, next one is a polygon. What is the polygon? See, come here. Now this is the forested area, I think. We have to generate that forested as a polygon here. See, in the polygon definition we can say when in the digitization the starting and ending is the same point, that will called as a polygon. I mean, suppose we started digitize here, will end here, that is the polygon. We can generate the polygon of this also, this portion also, that will all will, it will come in the polygon. Okay, now first we will select point, one by one we will go that one. Okay, now here we have to give the projection. Now here we have to go with the projected coordinate system. We are not going with the geographic coordinate system. Now here, what is that? That is the UTM zone 43 north. That is the projected coordinate system. One of our friend, he asked from our participant, he asked, sir, suppose we are going to use the projected coordinate system. In the projected coordinate system, that UTM zone 43 knot, it is correct. But how WGS 1984? Means WGS 1984, it is for geographic coordinate system. But suppose we are using the projected coordinate system, then how that WGS 1984 is there? Okay, that was his question. Very nice question and very logical question. But that explanation is that here our projection is this one, UTM zone 43 north. This is our projection. This is here, this is not a projection. This is the datum. What is that? This is the datum. Already I have told you what is the datum and what is the projection. Datum is a just vertical reference. Okay, datum is a vertical reference and zone is the, projection is the horizontal reference, means latitude and longitude. Okay, that is the difference between datum and the projection. In datum, we are just considering the reference. Means suppose in the reference of India, we are taking the Everest for India and nearby countries. Okay, when we are thinking about the worldwide, that time we are taking the this datum and this is the projection. This is the explanation of this one. Here we are not considering this as a projection. Okay, but suppose here this is the projection. Okay, there is one projection also and there is one datum also, WGS 1984. You just go with some theoretical material, you will clearly get this idea. But just remember this one. Whenever we are using the UTM zone, that is the projected coordinate system. Okay, and we are just going to use that one. I hope you have understood what till now we had discussed. Okay, now next one, that is the name. See here, new field. In the new field, we are going to use the name. What is the name? See here, what things we are going to do? We are going to do point. Okay. In that point, first thing, what we have to add? Suppose I would say what things are there. Point data, trees. Okay, trees. Now here, type. In the type, what we have to write? The text data, whole number, decimal number and date. Okay, now here in type, we have to add the text data. Suppose trees, we cannot give the text data because every tree doesn't have the name. Okay, we can categorize by the name, but we can give the number also, and in that we can give the decimal number also. I think you will not get the what is the exactly type. Means suppose you just remember the attribute table. Okay, in that attribute table, what things were there? ID number, sex ratio, child sex ratio, urban, rural, population, density, likewise. Same thing here we are going to do. Means we are generating our own data. Okay, in that own data, we are just giving the variables. Now see, here we can give the whole number, means tree number 1, 2, 3, like that. Then in that attribute table, same things will appear there. Just for practice, I am giving here. When you will do that actual practice, that time you will get each and everything. See, length. That length is giving the number. How many long we have to require number? 10 is the sufficient. When we'll click here, add to field list. See, it is appearing here. Trees, here in name, integer type, length 10. Okay, that is appearing there. Then we have to click the here on okay. Then what will happen? See that point data with the name test, it appeared here. Okay, now we have to start the digitization. Okay, when we have to start the digitization, that time we can do right click over here on this our created feature, and we can go to toggle editing. That is the one option, or here is that option. See, toggle editing. Or one minute, इन द लेयर टॉगल एडिटिंग फ्रॉम एनी वेयर यू कैन स्टार्ट दैट ऑप्शन इन दिस सॉफ्टवेयर और इन अदर सॉफ्टवेयर ऑल्सो दैट फंक्शन इट इज गिविंग द ऑन डिफरेंट वे वी कैन यूज एनी वे डजेंट मैटर बाय गो लेयर बाय गो राइट क्लिक और बाय गो दैट टूल बार मेनू ओके डायरेक्टली वी कैन क्लिक हियर वेन विल क्लिक हियर दैट टाइम सी दैट टाइम दिस ऑप्शन अपियर हियर एंड दिस ऑप्शन अपियर हियर सी वेन वी क्लिक हियर वेन वी क्लिक हियर दैट टाइम वी हैव इट विल आस्क टिल नाउ वी डिडंट स्टार्ट एनी डिजिटाइजेशन फर्स्ट वी हैव टू क्लिक हियर ओके देन वी हैव टू क्लिक हियर एड पॉइंट फीचर ओके we have to click here now our cursor will change in the form of point okay now see how it looks that is a like target okay and after that we can start our digitization what is our digitization that is in text file that is the trees then we by using the mouse we can zoom in or zoom out and by using that pen we can move the topo sheet And here we can use that points. Now where we can find that trees, we can give the name trees. These are the banks. We can generate data for the bank also, no problem. But now our this point is for the tree. Now here urban green. This portion is there. We can generate a point data for the each and every tree we can zoom in like this by using mouse you can use the touchpad also but I most feel comfortable with the mouse if you want to use touchpad you can use the touchpad also while using the laptop see I am just clicking here that point came here see when I will click left click here then this window will appear there okay then it is asking the ID and tree I am giving the number see I cannot write anything over here letters why because when we were creating the ID of that point that time we have given here the numbers if we would have given the letters that time it will appear in the letters now we'll give this one now see that points is there and it is added there likewise we'll add the all the points I'm just giving for reference or just practice you can do other also I will just give 10 4 Okay, 10. I'm just giving the 10 trees. Okay, now just go here, save for selected layers. Okay, just save. Then whatever things we have generated here, it got saved. Okay. Now here we have to go with the next. That is the line data. Okay. Again we have to go here create layer new shape file name again we have to give the file name text second here we have to change into line again here projection file road I'm giving here text earlier it was whole number here I am going to give the text for your understanding the different options you can change length suppose we give length only 5 and I have to give the road name suppose
I have to give the name of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Road. Then it is very difficult to write the within 5 letters. Then whatever sufficient we have to keep as it is. Okay, like that. I have given here the first field name road, string 80, and then here okay. Okay, it will appear here. Earlier it was test first. See, suppose you just observe here, this was the like point representation, line representation. Suppose you have to check out our earlier work here, you just right click here, go to zoom layer and just switch off this topo sheet. See, your point data, it is representing like that. Okay, now again I am clicking here, so it is should be there. I am just zoom to layer, our topo sheet is here, it is appearing here. It is our data is that much only, that's why it was zoom like that. Now we have to draw a line. In the line, before starting the design, the line data, first we have to go here project and we have to start the snapping options. This is very important. You just note down on your notebook also, this is very important, snapping option. Why it is important snapping option? Because see, suppose you are digitizing your road network. Okay, I am just clicking here, I'll just zoom in. See, Mumbai Pune bypass, this is the Mumbai Pune bypass, and we have to digitize this line feature. Okay, suppose we have started from here, we came up to here. Okay, then what we have to do, either we have to go this way or this way. Suppose we have digitized this way and we have finished at the end, wherever topo sheet will end, we will stop the digitization there. Again, what we have to do, either we have to start from this point to digitize this way, or we have to come from this way. But whenever we will meet here, that time, suppose that snapping option is open, that is on, that is enabled, that time automatically these two lines, this line and the old line, it will fit to each other, match, this like that, fit to each other. But sometime, suppose that option is not enabled, it is disabled, then what will happen? Suppose we are digitizing on very less zoom level, and we feel now our line, see, suppose this is our line and that two lines not touch each other, but on the our zoom level, what it will represent, it is touch each other, then that error will, it will be like that only. When we, and after end, when we will do the topology, that is also very important concept in the advanced GIS, that is the topology. After completion of all the digitization, we have to go with the topology, that time it will show that error. Okay, that's why that snapping option, it should be enabled. Okay, you do once, automatically you came to know what is exactly role of that option. But here I am just telling, whenever you are doing the linear feature, that time that snapping option should be on. See, when you click that snapping option, this is the toolbar. You can add directly that toolbar here also. Okay, it is not coming there. We have to click here. Okay, this first option, when you will click there, that time it will all option. Just 1 minute, we have to start the editing. Now I click here, this option enable, I click here, then this other option also enable, then project snapping option, click here. Now this, see, these options are enabled. See, it is asking either you have to do snapping to all layers, active layers and advanced configuration. Then we can give the active layer. Now see, it is asking different options, vertex or segment and segment. Okay, you just check out what is that vertex and segment. Okay, I will give here vertex and segment. Okay, these are the different options. Now here again, what is this 12, what is this pixel? See, when we are clicking on pixel or meter, suppose I will give first option, that is a pixel, and here is a 12. What is meaning of that? Okay, I will zoom in. Now see, this is our 1 pixel, this rectangle square, square. This is one square, okay. This is another square, this is third square, fourth square, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 12. I mean, what does it mean? When you will start your digitization, okay, suppose you are digitizing this way, you are coming to this way like this, okay, and after digitizing this line, you will go this way or this way. When you will come to nearby that line by 12 pixels, that time automatically it will get connect to each other. Got my point? Suppose I draw one line like this, okay, and I am digitizing another this line. Suppose your cursor is here only, okay, your pointer is here only, but by that near your old line is there, and the difference in between that two points is less than 12 pixel, then automatically it will get connect, need not to go nearby that. Or suppose some error is also there, that at that time within 12 pixel it will get connected to each other. It is pixel is also there and meter is also there, okay. Then suppose you are taking the meters, then you have to think about that, what is our study area, on which study area we are digitizing. See, now suppose you are considering meters, okay, this is the 12. Now think about that, 12 meters means near about, in a meter we are getting the 2.5 to 3 feet, okay. Now you have to think about the length of this highway, how much long length of this one, these two points, and where should we keep our cursor or our pointer, okay. According to that we have to take the decision, but instead of keeping that meters, it is pixel is easy to understand, because easily we can understand, okay, and we can keep the 20 also, okay. 20 is enough. When we will draw this line here and nearby 20, it will get connected. Now see, topological editing and snapping in intersection. The same things I was explaining here. See, here is this cross mark. Cross mark means this point. Automatically they are snapping on intersection. This is also intersection point. At that point it will get the connected snapping. And topological editing, that was I was discussing, when we'll go to build the topology, that time automatic it will get connected, okay. That in that case, that is the this snapping option is very important in the case of when we are digitizing the linear feature. Now exactly we'll start the digitization. Okay, when we'll click here, we have to use the pan button here, and again we have to switch. We have to start the editing. Now that that color is red, that's why it is not that much visible, but for your understanding we'll just take here. See, now it is visible. Now see that lines. Now see, now your cursor is there, and how to go downside, I am pressing the middle button and I am pushing that top sheet. Next one, you can do this one also, or you can use your keypad also. Whenever you will get familiar with these all buttons, then it will be easy for the understanding. And you can use the pan also for like this, but again you have to go here, then again you have to do the digitization. One important thing is that your zoom level is also very important, how much zoom you are taking. Suppose you are doing digitization on this level, then you will get the very less accuracy, okay. When your zoom level is like that, this much is sufficient. Now see, I am going this way. We'll just finish. See our digitization is going to see the red color. You will get visible on this color, because on red color both are the red colors, it not visible. You can change that color also. I will show you. First let me complete this one. You can change the size also. Okay, I will stop my editing here. Okay, till now we have done the point data, line data, digitization. Okay, suppose we take all the points, point, line, polygon, everything, that will be an overburden to you in a day to complete all these tasks. Actually, this digitization is near about 8 days practical. In that practical session, it is a big program. In that big program, we can digitize a topo sheet. We can take each and every point regarding point, all points regarding line, all points regarding the polygon. But here we do not have that much sufficient time. That's why we are covering the maximum point. But it should not like that. We are just covering maximum point and nothing to reaching to up to you. That's why today we'll stop here only. And after that, again, in the way today we started the previous part, tomorrow again we'll start with this part. We'll continue. This part will carry forward this part, and then we'll go to with the next topic. Up to here, you just try to point and line. You understand how to do that things, how to do this digitization with that point and line. If you familiar with that, then again we'll move next. Okay, already we'll completed our today's time period. We have to stick with the time. You just finish this one, these two things. If you feel any difficulty in that, let me know. Again, we'll discuss on that and we'll continue our work. But again, we suppose that multi-point and polygon, again, suppose we take that one, then it will be a more burden to you. Just finish this part. Again, tomorrow we'll continue the same one. Thank you. Thank you very much. Good day.